In this video, we'll discuss the various phases of the cell cycle, as well as the difference between cell growth and cell division. Have you ever wondered how, when you damage an area of skin, it heals itself? How does it happen? Cell division is the process through which a cell divides to make two daughter cells, each genetically identical to its parent cell. And there are two types, mitosis and meiosis. Typically, when people refer to cell division, they're usually talking about mitosis. Part of the cell cycle, mitosis is the process through which the body makes new cells. Here are the steps. The first step of the cell cycle is interphase. Cells spend most of their life in interphase. Cellular DNA is copied to form two of each chromosome, ready for mitosis to begin. Mitosis begins with prophase. The chromosomes condense into more visible X-shaped structures, each consisting of two sister chromatids with identical genetic information. The nuclear envelope breaks down, and the mitotic spindle, a structure that contains microtubules and some other proteins, extends across the cell. Metaphase comes next. Chromosomes and their copies line up along the equator of the cell. The fibers of the spindle attach to each of the chromatids. Step 4. Anaphase. Sister chromatids of each chromosome are moved to opposite poles by spindle fibers. In the fifth step, telophase, the chromosomes, having moved to opposite poles, are decondensed, and the spindle fibers disappear. Organelles like the Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, and nucleolus reform. Mitosis is now complete. The last step of the cell cycle is cytokinesis. The single cell pinches in the middle and splits in two. As the cytoplasm is divided among the two daughter cells, organelles like mitochondria and plastids are distributed. And that's how most cells in the body divide. Now, moving on to meiosis. Meiosis is the type of cell division that produces egg and sperm cells. Cell division occurs twice during meiosis. Meiosis 1, in which chromosome pairs separate, and meiosis 2, in which sister chromatids separate. Both have the steps prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Meiosis 1 begins with prophase 1. Homologous chromosomes pair up and exchange fragments. Then metaphase 1 happens. Homologous chromosome pairs line up along the equator. In anaphase 1, these two homologs separate to opposite ends of the cell. And finally, there's telophase 1, in which two non-identical haploid cells form. Both newly formed daughter cells undergo meiosis 2, a shorter and more straightforward process. Beginning with prophase 2, their nuclear membrane breaks down and their chromosomes condense. Spindle tubules orchestrate metaphase and anaphase 2. The chromosomes are maneuvered to line up along the center and split into chromatids, which are then pulled to opposite poles of the cell. And finally, in telophase 2, the nuclear membrane reforms, spindle tubules break down, and the chromosomes decondense. The cell undergoes cytokinesis, leaving behind four non-identical haploid daughter cells. Be careful not to confuse mitosis and meiosis. Though they have similar steps with the same names, mitosis is the process of making two new body cells identical to their parent cells, and meiosis creates four sex cells, genetically distinct from their parents. These methods of cell division are distinct from cell growth. Cell growth refers to an increase in an individual's cell size. Its cell surface chromosome number and cytoplasmic mass all increase. In cell division, on the other hand, a parent cell is divided into two or more daughter cells, as we have seen. Thanks to mitosis, damaged skin can be healed as new cells are created to replace old ones. In fact, we're constantly generating new cells, especially in skin and muscle tissues. Billions of cells are replaced in your body each day. Today we've covered the steps of mitosis and meiosis, and how cell division is distinct from cell growth. Thanks for watching.